Yeah, so hello everyone. This video is regarding the next type of annealing process, that is spheroidizing. Now, this is the heat treatment process, which is the continuation of process annealing. Now, why I'm telling you this is spheroidizing independently cannot be carried out. Only before if process annealing treatment is conducted, then only spheroidizing can be carried out. Okay, and again, process annealing also cannot be independently done. Previously, if a low carbon steel is subjected to cold working process only, process annealing can be done. So they are all basically interrelated. Okay, so cold working followed by process annealing followed by spheroidizing. Mainly, we are improving the ductility of that low carbon steel. Okay, that is the reason. Anyway, so spheroidizing is a heat treatment process. As I told you, it's a continuation of process annealing, which is specifically carried out on steels which has a carbon content less than 0.3%. Now, when I say low carbon, I should be even specific about how much percentage of carbon I am referring to. So it is regarding less than 0.3%. So that's why on the graph also you can see that 0.3. So this process, spheroidizing, will be taking place, greater than 0.3. I'm very sorry, greater than 0.3. So that is the reason why you can see spheroidizing annealing on this line. Okay, so it's basically done on the carbon percentages more than 0.3 and up to 2%. Because obviously beyond 2% it is cast iron. Okay, so it is done on those carbon steels which has more than 0.3%. Now the effect of heating will cause the cementite phase, as you can see, it is of course a continuation of process annealing, means again it's carried out below the 727 degree Celsius. So what happens below 727, you know that cementite is there by iron carbon diagram, hope you know that. So what happens, the effect of that heating will cause that cementite phase to assume a globular or a spherical shape. Now as you can see this is all the cementite phase. Okay, but it's a matrix basically. On the matrix of the ferrite, you have cementite being present in the globular or in the spheroid structure, round. So it will cause the cementite phase to assume the globular structure on the matrix or on the surface of the ferritic phase. Okay, if you know that alpha ferrite is also active, cementite is also active below 727 degrees Celsius. So that, since it is in the formation of the spheroid, the name is called as spheroidizing. Okay, so what is the main purpose of this is to improve the machinability and facilitate the subsequent cold working process. Okay, so even like when cold working is done, there should not be any issue on the metal that it breaks or there is no deformation only. Basically, when I say machinability, it means that it should be able to deform the shape. Okay, so to strengthen the material so as to have the machinability easier, that is the reason why spheroidizing is done. Okay, so the process involves is like metal is heated to around 30 degrees Celsius, and for several hours it will be maintained at 30 degrees Celsius such that the metal completely becomes cementite. As I told you, cementite is very active at lower temperatures. So lower temperature as in we are referring to 30 degrees Celsius. So it will be completely cementite, and when cooled slowly, it is observed that cementite takes the form of a spheroid and it is seen in the matrix of minimum traces of alpha ferrite. Now when I say ferrite, it is alpha ferrite, not delta ferrite. Again, delta ferrite is active at higher temperatures, if you have seen the iron carbon diagram. Okay, so it is employed for the steels greater than 0.3% of carbon to transform the lamellar perlite to spheroidal cementite. Okay, so the main reason is that. Okay, And the most important thing that you should know is periodizing is not an independent heat treatment process. It is always the continuation of process annealing heat treatment process. Okay. Hope I'm clear. Again, the advantages and application, everything is in the textbook. So please refer the textbook. I have passed that in the slides. Okay. Thank you. In the next slide, I'll be discussing on stress relief annealing.